Hello friends, good to see you back, and we welcome you to a new episode. Today, we'll start with the budget for fiscal year 2023 that allows NASA to prepare a second moon lander next to SpaceX's Starship. Recently, on the 23rd of December, Congress passed the $1.7 trillion omnibus bill, which includes approval for $25.384 billion funding to NASA, which is a good boost for their space research programs. Though the funding was less than the $25.974 billion request put forward by the White House back in March 2022, as well as slightly less than the $25.446 billion offering from a House bill, but still the allocation is nearly 5.6% more than the $24.041 billion the agency received in fiscal year 2022. As per some reports, despite receiving 5.6% more budget, NASA will have to be cautious in spending in some sectors as they've much lesser funds compared to last year due to a good deal of inflation in the market. Report says that this recent budget approval includes full funding for a second Artemis program moonlander so that NASA can proceed with finding a second moonlander besides Starship. We all know how the first HLS bidding process ended in a heated situation when only SpaceX was selected with the Starship Lunar Landing System. Multiple protests and lawsuits had sparked out then. Keeping that situation in mind, Congress had directed NASA to find a second company for lunar landing services. And thus, it made NASA carry out the second Human Landing Systems HLS bidding process in December 2022. And before its closure on the 6th of December, Blue Origin-led National Team and another partnering duo of Leidos Dynetics and Northrop Grumman had signed up for proposing human landing services on the lunar surface. To meet NASA's budget constraints, Congress approved almost the same amount NASA requested for their exploration program and space operations. As per sources, the agency received $7.4 billion for the exploration programs, which included $1.486 billion for the Human Landing System program that NASA had earlier requested for development of a second lunar lander. Other than the lunar lander, this funding incorporated Orion, the Space Launch System, Exploration Ground Systems, and Artemis campaign development. But funding approval was not to the fullest on the science ground. Sources state NASA gets $7.795 billion for the science part, which is nearly $193.3 million less than the requested amount. Planetary science and heliophysics get more funding than requested. Astrophysics, earth science, and biological and physics sciences faced cutbacks in funding. The bill provided $90 million for the Near-Earth Object Surveyor mission, which is a space telescope meant to search for potentially hazardous objects in space. NASA had requested only $40 million for NEO Surveyor and planned to delay its launch to 2028. But Congress put emphasis on the development and launch of the telescope as soon as possible, and thus they provided more than double the requested amount. In a report accompanying the omnibus bill, Congress reminds NASA of its mandate to detect 90% of objects greater than 140 meters in size that threaten Earth. Though they received more than double the requested amount, NASA states that amount is not sufficient to keep the mission on its earlier schedule to launch in 2026. In space technology, NASA received $1.2 billion in place of requested $1.45 billion. But overall, the sector saw a $100 million rise over that of fiscal year 2022. The bill also provided funding for Mobile Launcher 2, a long-delayed platform needed for the Block 1B version of SLS, as well as funding for NASA's commercial LEO development effort to support work on commercial space stations to replace the International Space Station. For further provision, NASA also kept aside $10 million for developing an ISS deorbiting vehicle to be used after decommissioning of ISS. In our next update, we'll discuss SpaceX plans in response to NASA's request for options for extending service life of Hubble. Back in September 2022, NASA had signed an unfunded Space Act agreement with SpaceX to study a concept of sending a Crew Dragon spacecraft to the orbiting Hubble telescope to reboost and possibly service to extend the operational life of the telescope. Both NASA and SpaceX had stated that the proposed mission could possibly be made part of the Polaris program to better understand the technical challenges associated with servicing missions. At that time, NASA had stated that teams expect the study to take up to 6 months, collecting technical data from both Hubble and the SpaceX Dragon spacecraft. The data will help determine whether it will be possible to safely rendezvous, dock, and move the telescope into a more stable orbit. NASA's also mentioned that they'd be open to similar agreements with other companies. Following that announcement, SpaceX has started conducting a non-exclusive study to see if it's possible to reboost the flying observatory and give it new life. Nearly 3 months after the agreement, on the 22nd of December, NASA's recently published a Request for Information (RFI) to search for commercial options available in the industry for servicing and raising the orbit of Hubble. This really shows how NASA is flexible in going beyond SpaceX and seeking other viable options if available. However, NASA has also clarified that there are no plans at this time for NASA to conduct or fund a dedicated Hubble servicing mission. The RFI stated, "With a growing commercial space industry, developing and maturing space technologies and capabilities, NASA seeks to partner with commercial entities to demonstrate capabilities to operate and provide in-space services." And regarding the mission, it says, "Partners would be expected to participate and undertake this mission on a no-exchange-of-funds basis, as we can see how the NASA-SpaceX agreement was an unfunded one." Thomas Zurbuchen, Associate Administrator at NASA, said, "This study is an exciting example of the innovative approaches NASA is exploring through private-public partnerships. As our fleet grows, we want to explore a wide range of opportunities to support the most robust, superlative science missions possible." After publishing the RFI document, the agency confirmed that SpaceX's non-exclusive study for boosting Hubble is ongoing. The Hubble Space Telescope has been operating in an orbit around Earth since the 1990s and has not only helped humans look beyond the solar system, but also find exoplanets, nebulas, and other cosmic phenomena. And most recently, it's completed over 1 billion seconds in space during its 31-year-long career in zero gravity. The telescope was deployed in an orbit nearly 600 kilometers above Earth's surface. Presently, it orbits at an altitude of 540 kilometers above the planet. NASA says that reboosting Hubble into a higher, more stable orbit could add multiple years of operation to its life. At the end of its lifetime, NASA plans to safely deorbit or dispose of Hubble. During the Inspiration 4 mission, SpaceX's Dragon spacecraft had flown over 500 kilometers above Earth, so it's expected that Dragon may be able to boost Hubble's orbit. According to NASA, the aim of this mission would actually be to find and test a capability that can be used to raise the orbits of other satellites in the future. As per reports, NASA has set the 24th of January as the last date to receive responses from commercial space service companies. Though when NASA will take up such a mission is not sure, but according to the published document, it's stated Hubble will fall back to 500 kilometers altitude in 2025, and at that point boosting options will be more difficult. So it's expected that if NASA plans to save Hubble, then they will opt for a boost back mission before 2025.
Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.